ನಮಸ್ತೆ ವೀಕ್ಷಕರೇ, ನೀವು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ವಾಣಿ ನ್ಯೂಸ್. ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ದನಿ, ನಾನು ಅಕ್ಷತಾ ಭಟ್. ರಾಜ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊರೋನಾ ಹೆಚ್ಚುತ್ತಿರುವ ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಪ್ರದೇಶ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಸಮಿತಿ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷ ಡಿಕೆ ಶಿವಕುಮಾರ್ ಅವರು ಕೊರೋನಾ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಜನಜಾಗೃತಿ ಮೂಡಿಸಲು ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ ಮೂಲಕ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಜನರ ಬಳಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಪೋಲೋ ಆಸ್ಪತ್ರೆ ತಜ್ಞ ವೈದ್ಯ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರವೀಂದ್ರ ನೇಹತ ಮತ್ತು ಖ್ಯಾತ ವೈದ್ಯ ದೇವಿ ಪ್ರಸಾದ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ ಮುಂತಾದವರೊಂದಿಗೆ ಸರಣಿ ಚರ್ಚೆಗಳನ್ನು ನಡೆಸಲಿದ್ದು ಸಾರ್ವಜನಿಕರು ಇದರ ಪ್ರಯೋಜನ ಪಡೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳಬಹುದು. ಕಾರ್ಯಕಾರಿ ಸಂಪಾದಕರು ಚಿಕ್ಕರಸು ಹುಲ್ಲೂರು, ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ವಾಣಿ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು.
ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಇವತ್ತು ನಾವು ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಬಹಳ ಕಷ್ಟದ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಇಡೀ ವಿಶ್ವ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನ ಅಲುಗಾಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ವಿಶ್ವದ ಈ ಒಂದು ಮಹಾಮಾರಿ ಎಲ್ಲರನ್ನೂ ಅಲುಗಾಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಇದಕ್ಕೇನಾದ್ರೂ ನಾವು ವಾಸ್ತವಾಂಶನ ತಿಳಿಬೇಕು. ಈ ವಿಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆನ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಎದುರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು, ಈ ಕಾಯಿಲೆಯನ್ನು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಎದುರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಜನರ ಹತ್ರ ಅನೇಕ ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ಪ್ರಜೆಗಳ ಹತ್ರ ಹಂಚ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನವನ್ನು ನಾನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಇವತ್ತು ಕೋವಿಡ್ನ ಎರಡನೇ ಅಲೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕೈ ಮೀರಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಇದರ ವಿರುದ್ಧ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಒಗ್ಗಟ್ಟಿಂದ ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲ ಜಾತಿ ಧರ್ಮ ರಾಜಕಾರಣ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಒಗ್ಗೂಡಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿ ಇದನ್ನು ಹೆದರಿಸಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ. ಈ ಮಹಾಮಾರಿ ವಿರುದ್ಧ ನಾವು ಹೋರಾಟವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಾನು ಈ ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ ಲೈವ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ತಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾತಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನವನ್ನು ನಾನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಇದನ್ನು ಈ ಮಾಸ್ಕನ್ನು ನಾನು ತೆಗಿತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ನಾನು ನಮ್ಮ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ನ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಯಾರೋ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಹಾಕ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸಾಕು ಅಂತ ಅವರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಅವರ ಸಲಹೆ ಮೇರೆಗೆ ನಾನು ಈ ಒಂದು ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಟುಡಿಯೋನಲ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನ ಮನೆಯಿಂದ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ನಾನು ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಇದು ನನ್ನ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿರುವಂಥ ಸ್ಟುಡಿಯೋ. ಇವತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಅತಿಥಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ನಗರದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಳ ಶ್ರೇಷ್ಠವಾದಂಥ ಒಬ್ಬ ಡಾಕ್ಟರು, ರವೀಂದ್ರ ಮೆಹ್ತಾರ್ ಅವರು. ನಾನು ಕೊರೋನಾ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟ್ಲಲ್ಲಿ ಅಡ್ಮಿಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ಬಹುಶಃ ನಾನೊಬ್ಬ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಮಂತ್ರಿ ಕೂಡ. ಸೊ ನಾನೆಲ್ಲ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಯಾರ ಹತ್ರ ಹೋಗಿ ಸೇರಬೇಕು ಅಂತೇಳಿ. ನೂರಾರು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸು ನನ್ನ ಸಂಪರ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಕೊನೆಗೆ ಅವರೆಲ್ಲ ನನಗೆ ಬೆಟ್ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ದು ನೀವು ಅಪೋಲೋದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂಥ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರವೀಂದ್ರ ಮೆಹ್ತಾರ್ ಅವರ ಕೈ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಹೋಗಿ ನೀವು ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ನಾನು ಮೊದಲನೇ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟ್ಲಿಂದ ವಾಪಸ್ ಬಂದು ಎರಡೇ ದಿನಕ್ಕೆ ವಾಪಸ್ಸು ಸೇರಬೇಕಾದಂಥ ಒಂದು ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಬಂತು. ನಾನು ಅಲ್ಲೋಗಿ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದಂಥ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ನನಗೆ ಈ ಕೊರೋನಾ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು. ನಾನು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮೊದಲು ಉಡಾಫೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಹಂತದಲ್ಲಿ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನನಗೆ ಈ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಉಸಿರಾಟದ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ಇದರ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿತು. ಇದರ ನಾವು ಎಷ್ಟು ಹುಷಾರಾಗಿರಬೇಕು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನನ್ನನ್ನು ಒಬ್ಬ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಮಂತ್ರಿನ, ಒಬ್ಬ ಪಿ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರೋನ್ನ ಅವರು ನನಗೆ ಆರೈಕೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಧೈರ್ಯ ತುಂಬಿ ಕಳಿಸ್ಕೊಟ್ರು. ಅವರು ಅಮೇರಿಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಒಂದು ನಮ್ಮ ಉಸಿರಾಟದ ವಿಚಾರ ಖ್ಯಾತ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಕೋಶ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರವೀಂದ್ರ ಅವರು ಅಮೇರಿಕದಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಭಾಳ ಪ್ರವೀಣತೆಯನ್ನು ಪಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರು ಉತ್ತಮವಾದಂಥ ಪಲ್ಮಾಲಜಿಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ. ಸೊ ಅವ್ರದ್ದೊಂದು ಹೆಸರೇ ನಮ್ಮ ರಾಜ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಳ ಜನ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಬಟ್ ಇವರು ಭಾಳ ಸರಳತೆಯಿಂದ ಭಾಳ ಧೈರ್ಯ ತುಂಬಿ ನಮ್ಮಂಥವ್ರನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಕಳಿಸ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡೆ, ಅವರು ಇವತ್ತು ಒಂದು ಗಂಟೆಗಳ ಕಾಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆ ಇದ್ದು ಜನರಿಗೆ ಅನೇಕ ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ಹಂಚ್ಕೊಳ್ತೇನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಭಾಳ ನಮ್ಮ ಮೇಲೆ ವಿಶ್ವಾಸ ಇಟ್ಟು, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮೇಲೆಲ್ಲ ವಿಶ್ವಾಸ ಇಟ್ಟು ಸಮಾಜನ ಬದಲಾವಣೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಸಮಾಜಕ್ಕೆ ಜ್ಞಾನವನ್ನು ತುಂಬಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಸಮಾಜ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಇರಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇವತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರವೀಂದ್ರ. ಐ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಯು ಸರ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ತಮಗೆ ನಾನು ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಬಯಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಇದು ಎರಡನೇ ಮಹಾಮಾರಿ, ಭಾಳ ಕಷ್ಟದ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿಯಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕನ್ನಡ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತದಷ್ಟೇ, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಮಾತಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಬೇರೆ ಭಾಷೆಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ರು ಮಾತಾಡೋಷ್ಟು ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಅದರಿಂದ ನಾನು ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ನಲ್ಲೇ ಕೆಲವು ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾತಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಅವರು ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ನಲ್ಲೇ ಉತ್ತರ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಕೆಲವು ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ನಿಮಗೆ ತರ್ಜುಮೆ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಕೆಲಸ ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಸೊ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆನ್ ಬಿಹಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಿಟಿಸನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾಲೋವರ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆಲ್ ಓವರ್ ದಿ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಶೋ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್, ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು, ಹೌ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೇವ್? ಈ ಹೊಸ ವೇವ್, ಹೊಸ ಅಲೆ ಏನು, ಮೊದಲಕ್ಕಿನ್ನ ಈಗ ಏನು ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದೆ? ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಆಸ್ಕ್.
ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಲವ್ಲಿ ಇನಿಷಿಯೇಟಿವ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಜುಕೇಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಈವನ್ ದೋ ವಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್, ವೆನ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಮೀ ಮೈ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಆಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸ್ಕೇರ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲೈಸ್ಡ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಕೇರ್ಡ್. So I think using forums such as this to educate people is a very, very good idea. And thank you for calling me and giving me the chance to doing this. The next thing you asked is a very, very important question which everybody in the world is asking. Every person, every leader, every government and every doctor. How did this become so horrible? When we were relaxing in December and we were congratulating ourselves in January and February, suddenly in April it has come and it is going at the speed of lightning, like a thunderbolt it has hit our country. And so the difference in this wave is that it seems to be different because it is spreading very rapidly, very, very rapidly. Secondly, it is coming at a point where we opened up our economy. So we thought that we are safe, it is okay to move around and have our functions and go to our restaurants and have marriages and so on. But that is the reason it is spreading very fast also. Thirdly, everybody is tired. You know, 1 year we've been saying masking, social distancing is very difficult. Fourthly, we are schools, our children, they all want to go out also. So this is what has led to society opening. And lastly, the virus, this little tiny virus we cannot see is brilliant. It is smarter than all of us humans when you think that we are so intelligent, because it is able to spread so fast and it does not leave any notice. So a very fast active virus, a public which is moving around, an economy which opened, everybody who is tired is leading to this massive wave. Now here is the thing to understand with COVID. COVID, once it starts, nobody can stop it. There is a run, and that run is very difficult to control. So this is what we're going through right now. Aggressive virus, opened economy, people mixing, and a very rapid spread which is leading to all this worry. And I think a lot of the information we give today should help you to understand and calm down and take charge of your particular situation.
Doctor, is this something new strain? Has this virus actually gone through the mutation?
Yeah, so it is a lovely question because it helps us to understand. So if you look at what is going on in other countries, typically, fortunately, India followed America, UK, Italy and so on. So in the information comes from currently UK and America mostly at this point. In UK, they realized that whatever happened in UK in December was because of the UK strain. They've given it a name also. That UK strain spread like wildfire. Nobody was able to stop it at that point. And when they identified test by testing, they came to know. At this point in India, we are testing all this. There is a whole association who is looking into all these 10 laboratories. But the suspicion is, yes, there is a mutant strain. And the mutant strain, whether it is the UK strain, the Brazilian strain, the South Indian strain, and everything in India, Atmanirbhar is here also, unfortunately. Our own strain has also come. So our Indian strain has also come here, which is called the double mutant strain and a Bengal strain. So many of these are there, all fellows who are spreading very fast. And that is a suspicion that the mutant strain is leading to this wildfire-like spread, much worse than 2020.
Why are more people getting affected this time, doctor? Because jaasti jana idike affect aagta idiyala ee sathi kaana eno?
So that's a very important point right now. Last time when it came, and it came to my family, if I got it, then one or two people would get it. My wife would get it, 50% chance, remaining would be 10-20%. This time when it comes to my family, everybody is getting it. You know, 80-100% spread. There is one family in Lucknow, 11 families with 10 members each, all have got infected. So it is a very infective strain. Like we said 5 to 7 minutes ago, it is mutant most likely. It is very infective. Secondly, our precautions have dropped. And this time the virus is spreading like wildfire. So yes, very, very infective, different from last time. we cannot say that the last time lessons we can follow. This time we have to be very, very, very cautious. And that is why you see, even in this conversation, we are being very careful that my mask is on so that we are taking care of everybody, even in such a situation where we are socially distanced.
Okay, doctor. What precaution we have to take at this point of time? Now, yeno jagrutaragirbeku ee sandarbhadalli.
So this is one of the times COVID-19 has shown that we do not need to depend on somebody else. You know, we tend to cry, family help me, government help me, employer help me, everybody help me. First thing we have to do is help ourselves. So a little knowledge, not much intelligence required. Everybody knows how to eat, goes to work, earns some money. Same intelligence is required here. We have to be aware that every time we meet any human being, we have to maintain this particular thing now. So in our hand lies the ability to control this particular mutant virus. In short, billion times it must be said, this particular thing is gold right now. There is no gold in your family. There is no gold in your rings. It is gold is here. Mask and social distancing. And out of that, these two things, if we can quietly follow for some time, become part of our culture, then we can start individually helping everybody else to beat the virus.
Doctor, in my house, I naturally sit with my daughter, I sit with my son, I sit with my wife. We will be together, we live together. So nanu nammaneli nan kutumbadavar jothe nan tamdira nan maga nan magalu nan henti jothele navella jothele irthivi jothele malagbekagutade ella irthave kaaru jothele odadbekagutade idu idrinda yenaru samasya aagtada.
So there is no right answer. It is a question which basically one thinks about today. The newspaper says a headline which has never been seen before in the history of COVID-19. The center has said, start masking at home. If you open any newspaper, it is there now. Which means that if all of us share one house, and he goes outside and I go outside, and I get asymptomatic COVID, and I sit here and I talk, tiny, tiny particles are collecting out here. When my daughter, my wife, my brother comes in, he's going to inhale that. The chances of transmission are hitting 70 to 80%. So at this point, unfortunately, any member who goes out and comes back home has to have some sort of simple mask with the family also, if possible. Now, what am I saying? Is it practical? I know it's not practical. It's not easy to sit in one house and do it. But currently, if we can form some discipline that if we go out, we have to come back and be very cautious. If nothing else, have a little distance from people. If nothing else, have a ventilated house. And again, if you're going to meet multiple people, it may be a good time that for the next some amount of time, we at least wear this mask even at home. Today is the day when he has made me change this statement. If you asked me till 2 days ago, this statement was not part of it. My home, my family members who I grew up with are my loved ones and they are safe. Currently, nobody is safe right now. So this is something we have to watch very carefully. Good news for you. Younger people will by and large get only mild COVID. So whatever it is, even if you get it, you should be able to manage at home, which we will also be talking about a little later.
Okay. What are the symptoms, doctor? Vasa COVID, second wave nalli, yen symptoms barbodu? What are the symptoms which we have to be careful about it?
So that is the good part of it. You know, we don't like change in humanity. We like to have the same thing. So this COVID in terms of symptoms is not very different from last COVID. In the last COVID, it was like any viral illness. Lifelong, I get my viral illness per year. What happens in that? I'll get a little fever. I won't feel good. I'll feel tired. I'll have a little runny nose, some scratchy throat irritation, body ache, lethargy. And typical was that loss of taste and loss of smell. Nothing much has changed over here. Those same things are there. But understand one major message. Today, I repeat, today if anybody gets any fever or body ache, it is by and large COVID. To be ruled out. If we are lucky, then the other friendly fellows, the old viruses, some little malaria, dengue may be there. But by and large, today, everything seems to be COVID. This may change in 2, 4, 6 weeks as the numbers come down. But anybody who calls you, make sure that you understand, because testing is not easy. So you may have to make sure that you basically move away from your elderly mother, family member and all, so that you do the right thing for yourself and for them.
Doctor, with anyone who doesn't have a COVID symptoms, from him anything can be caught, can be transferred?
Very important message to give out. So this is called asymptomatic COVID. So I'll become a little technical and you have to forgive me, and sir can add to this. This is zero, day zero. Nothing is going on. Today this virus comes here. It comes into here. The time to develop symptoms is day five. Now, I mean, if I develop symptoms, this is COVID. Before this 2 days, it is called pre-symptomatic, which means that the virus is inside. I'm going to develop day after tomorrow, but I am there, I'm able to infect. So that is when I start infecting people. I don't know I have the virus. Nobody knows I have the virus. My symptoms are not there, but 2 days before I can infect people. Second category, even more dangerous. I don't develop any symptoms at all. My body stops, does not cause fever. There is no body ache, nothing. But I go through what's called asymptomatic COVID. These people also are spreading the virus. That is the reason why this is becoming so problematic, because if we have 100 people, most of them are asymptomatic or pre-symptomatic, and because if I don't know I'm sick, why should I take any precautions? So that is why the spread is happening so fast, and that is why these difficult decisions, as we said, wear the mask wherever you are at this point. I tell you a funny story. Children who are born nowadays don't even know that humans don't have a mask. They see all their mothers, fathers with the mask. So if you catch any one-year-old, he is wondering why, when we take off the mask, who is this fellow coming in front of me?
Doctor, one important issue. How cautious we should be at first stage?
Right. So when we get COVID, so it has, first thing we have to do is knowledge.
Because we can't get in hospital, we can't get to be registered, we can't go to beds. Financially, ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಆರ್ಥಿಕವಾದಂಥ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕೆ ಅವಮಾನ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಈಗ ಯಾರೇ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋದರೆ 3 ಲಕ್ಷ, 5 ಲಕ್ಷ, 10 ಲಕ್ಷವರೆಗೂ ಖರ್ಚಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಕಾಗ್ತಾಯಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಈಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಜನ ಬಡ ಜನತೆ ದೇಕಾಂಡ್, ಈಗ ನಾನೇ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೆ, ನನಗೆ 7-8 ಲಕ್ಷ ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಖರ್ಚಾಯಿತು, ನಂತರ ಎಲ್ಲರ ಕೈಲೂ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಆತ ಫಸ್ಟು ಈ ನೀವು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋಂಥ ಕಾಯಿಲೆ ಬಂದಾಗ, ನೀವು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋಂಥ ಜ್ವರ ಬಂತು ಅಂದಾಗ, ನೀವು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋಂಗೆ ಮೈಕೈ ನೋವು ಬಂತಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ, ಆತ ಏನು ಪ್ರಿವೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೋದು? ಫಸ್ಟು ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟ್ಲಿಗೆ ಸೇರೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚಿತವಾಗಿ ತಾನು ತನ್ನ ಈ ವೈದ್ಯಕೀಯ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆನ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೋದು?
ಸೊ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ಡೂ ಐ ಡೂ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಕೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ನಾಟ್ ಗೋ ಟು ಎನಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮನಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಎನಿ ವೇ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಬೆಡ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ನೌ. ಇಟ್ ಟುಡೇ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರೀಚ್ಡ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನೆವರ್ ಸೀನ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಲೈಫ್. ಈವನ್ ಮೈ ಮನಿ ಕೆ ನಾಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಕೇರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹೋಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 2 to 3 weeks. So the first thing to understand is, when I get first symptom of COVID, is first thing is knowledge is power. You must understand a few things, and this conversation is helping, and we, there are tens of resources. We can even share something with you which is very, very simple. So first thing is, I must know what to do. This is not very difficult. If you manage your life, you can understand this. Second is good news for us. Fortunately, when the first COVID news came, 80% of people were not going to have any problem. In India, that number is 90%. 90% of us will not have any problem. This information will calm me down, get my heart rate down, not make me sweat and run to doctors. Thirdly, when we look at last year, everybody ran to the hospital. We don't need to go to the hospital anymore on day one. The hospital, in fact, is one place I would tell you as a doctor, please don't come at all. Nothing good will come out of it. So at this point, what we have to do is calm down, see our symptoms. We start measuring, we checking fever. We look for the oxygen saturation. Fortunately, in a city like Bangalore and most parts, this oximeter has become like one more simple food item only. So you can check your oximetry and then realize if your oxygen level is good, which is more than 96-97%, monitor your fever and then get in touch with the doctor.
So, doctor, you are telling, first you have the oximeter. ₹1,000. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಇದನ್ನ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, 95 ಇದೆಯಾ, 96 ಇದೆಯಾ, 97 ಎಷ್ಟುವರೆಗೂ ಅದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಸುಧಾರಣೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಟಿಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಡು ಯು ಟೆಲ್?
ಸೊ ಅಸ್ಯೂಮಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಮೈ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬೀನ್ ಅ ಸ್ಮೋಕರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನೋ ಲಂಗ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್, 96-97 ಅಂಡ್ ಅಬವ್ ಇಸ್ ಗುಡ್. 98 and 99 ಇಸ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್, ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವರೇಜ್. ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಫಾಲ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಫೀಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫೀವರ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಫೀಲ್ ಅ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕರ್, body ethanol may be there, and the oxygen falls to something like 93-94. Now, when it falls to 93-94, I should not rush, worry and run. First of all, make sure the oximeter is correct. Ladies, take off your nail polish. Nail polish is not a good thing for oximetry. Put it on again, put 2-3 fingers. Then walk for 3-4 minutes. Anybody can walk. Walk for 3-4 minutes, see. If the oxygen increases, that means by and large there may not be a problem. If the oxygen falls, again 93-94 as he said, or it goes down, it means the disease is progressing, you need help. That help has to be decided that do I need to get into a hospital or do I need a change of medication. The major change of medication we will talk about.
Sir, doctor, ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಒಂದು 1000 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆಕ್ಸಿಮೀಟರ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಒಳ್ಳೇದು ಅಂತೀರಾ?
ಯಾ ಯಾ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಶೇರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ವೈ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಒನ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ 10 ಆಕ್ಸಿಮೀಟರ್ಸ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಇಟ್ ಅ ಲಿಟಲ್, ಎನಿಬಡಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಇಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸಿಟ್ ಇನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮೈ ಹೌಸ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಆ ಗನ್ ಏನೋ ಇಟ್ಟು ಇದಂತ ಥರ್ಮೋಮೀಟರ್ ದೇನ
ಗನ್ ಸರ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಾನ್. ಗನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹೈ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್, ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಆರ್ ಲೋ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಚಸ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್. ಬಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಗನ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಟ್ರಿ how it is and it is not very useful, I think. So it is, it makes me feel nice to make sure that I did not let anybody with fever come into my house or into my office. But if they are normal also, they can very well have COVID and that will not be useful.
Okay. Doctor, ega within the family, ega now travel, ega now ella ban aagibidide, ellu horagade hogilla madangilla ega mikku major point, ega now manele irthivi. ನಮ್ಮ ವಿ ಆಲ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಹೌಸ್, ಇನ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಹೌಸ್ ಹೌಸ್. ಸೊ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ನಾವು ಹೆಂಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಒಬ್ಬರು ನಾವು ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸು ಇರಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಹೇಳ್ತೀರಿ? ವಾಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್, ವಾಟ್ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್?
ಸೊ ಕರೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 15
ಡೇಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಹೋದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ತೊಂದರೆ ಆದಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವರೆಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ. ಈಗ ಮನೇಲೇ ಇರೋಂಥ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಹುಷಾರಾಗಿರಬೇಕು. ನಮ್ಮನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಮನೇಲಿ ಕೂಡಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಈಗ ಕೂಡಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಈಗ ನಾವು ಹೆಂಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು?
ಸೊ ದ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಐ ಗೆಟ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಟಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ, ಟೂ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ, ಟೂ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಮೀ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೈ ಸರೌಂಡಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಐಸೋಲೇಟ್ ಮೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಲಕ್ಕಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ರೂಮ್, ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ರೂಮ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಬಾತ್ರೂಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು, ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅವೇ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯು, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಮೀಟ್ ದಮ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಮೀಟ್ ದಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಮಾಸ್ಕ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಟು ಸೇ ಶೂ ಶು ಗೋ ಅವೇ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೋ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಎನಿ ಮೋರ್. Secondly, in the past, we used to spray everything. Please stop spraying everywhere. Spraying is not going to help anybody. Ultimately, besides wasting sanitizer and killing a whole bunch of organisms, we are not doing anything. So the main thing is isolation, masking, staying separate from the family till the test is done or for 10 days by and large, and maintaining that distance is the only thing to do. Now, the only worry is that by the time I get an infection, there is a good chance I have already given it to the family. If I am going to give it to my wife, then she will develop symptoms 5-7 days from then. So first take care of yourself, consult a doctor as we said, monitor your stuff, keep away from the family, and in the next 5-7 days, see if the family also requires testing. Also, family should not go out, sir. There is no point that the family says, okay, and we are going. Everyone becomes a primary contact. So if we want to work as a community, a city, a state and a country, all of us should stay in that isolation within that family until we come to know that we are COVID negative.
Okay, doctor, government has announced that they will vaccinate everyone. Lot of discussion has taken place, lot of issues have come out. Should we get vaccinated? ನಮಗೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನ್ ತಗೋಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನೀವೇನಾದ್ರು ಸೂಚನೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ?
ಸೊ
ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿನಾ?
ಸೊ ಕರೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ದ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಟ್ ಜನವರಿ ಟು ಮಾರ್ಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಾರ್ಚ್ ಟು ನೌ, ಜನವರಿ ಟು ಮಾರ್ಚ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅ ವಿಂಡೋ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಹನಿಮೂನ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟು ಕೋವಿಡ್ಸ್, ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಎ, ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಬಿ ಆರ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವೇವ್, ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ವೇವ್. That time the vaccine came into the country and everybody was asking this vaccine, that vaccine, this risk, that risk, why should I take? Because we thought life is normal. Come March end or April, we are all gone because COVID is spreading so much that now we are back into our houses. The only long-term way out of this is vaccination. There is no other way right now.
Okay, doctor, you are telling I should take the vaccination.
Vaccination is a must.
It is compulsory. But yeah. One thing you should kindly ask. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ಮೀ, ಈ ದೇಶದ ಪ್ರಧಾನಮಂತ್ರಿ, ಈ ದೇಶದ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿ, ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಎಂ ಎಲ್ ಎಗಳು ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವೈ ದೇ ಆಸ್ ಟು ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ವೈ ದೇ ಆಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಂಗನವಾಡಿ ವರ್ಕರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ವೈ ದೇ ಆಸ್ ಆಶಾ ವರ್ಕರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ವೈ ಡಿಂಟ್ ದೇ ಟೇಕ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಬಿಗ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಐ ಟುಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಟುಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಒನ್ ಮಂತ್ ಆರ್ ಫಿಫ್ಟೀನ್ ಡೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪೆನ್
ಸೊ ದ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಟು ಹೂ ಶುಡ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನೇಟೆಡ್ do the leaders, does Mr. Shivakumar have a greater right to the vaccine than anybody else, than his driver? It comes down to that. The policy which is borrowed, it is actually a borrowed policy from other parts of the world, take the frontline workers first, healthcare workers, other frontline workers, then take the people who are above 60 with comorbidities. By comorbidities, we mean diabetes, blood pressure, heart issues, and then you come to the younger population. My understanding is that most leaders are trying to say that we are not frontline workers. We come under category 3, which means that we are more than 60 with comorbidities, and so we will go in line. So the first time in our lives we have seen going in line. So that is the only explanation we have. Currently, if you look at all that, that is history. I think anybody who can stand on his feet and reach a center should be getting a injection at this point, assuming we have enough stock of the vaccine.
ಓಕೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್, ಈಗ ನಮಗೆ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಮ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಟಮ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ರೀಚಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಹೌಸಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಸ್ಟೈನ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಬ್ರೀತಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು, ನಮಗೆ ಜ್ವರ ಬಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಸೇರಬೇಕು, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ?
ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ವರಿಸಮ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ನೋ ವಿ ಹೋಪ್ ದಟ್ ನನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಕೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಕೋವಿಡ್, ಸಂಬಡಿ ಹಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮೀ, ಐ ಟುಕ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೆಟಮಾಲ್, ಮೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಸ್ಯಾಚುರೇಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ he will show you is all okay. You can demonstrate over there. So all that is okay. But what happens usually, COVID problems come in the second week. First 6 to 7 days is usually okay. None of us have any major issues. But after seven days...
95, doctor.
See?
I'm okay?
Yeah, yeah. Once he takes a few... We are talking a lot over here. So I think if we take a few deep breaths, it will
94.
Go. We will watch for some time.
Okay.
So this is the oximeter. In principle, this is a simple oximeter which we have over here right now. So coming back to the original issue which we asked me is that when do we get worried and what is the thing? So day 7 onwards, the oxygen starts falling usually in people who are going to get into trouble. Once the oxygen starts falling, it means we are in trouble, and that is the time either we need a hospital. If we cannot get a hospital, and I say that with a lot of pain, then we have to quickly do something. One is oxygen therapy. So we have to try and get oxygen therapy, and there are medications which are given called steroid medication.
What is oxygen therapy and what is oxygen therapy?
Exactly. So oxygen means that what my body cannot produce, basically I have to give from outside. But before that, ladies and gentlemen, there is one secret which medical science will share. Before you can arrange oxygen, which is so difficult, there is one simple way. You must lie on your stomach. We all were born as children when we lie down on our stomach. Now most of us prefer to be on our back or on the side. But if you just lie down on the stomach, oxygen will improve by anywhere from 4 to 6. So if I am 92, 89, 90, I will improve to 93, 94.
So,
exactly. And he has done it so well when we asked him.
Hospital.
He was very well, he was doing it. Yeah. We just had to say, sir, just do this. And 18 hours a day, sir was doing all this.
Hospital.
So very important, exactly. That before you go asking, give me bed, give me oxygen, you do that. Then if it is falling further and doesn't help, we have some time, then somehow we have to try for a hospital bed. But if the bed is not there, as is happening right now, then many attempts are being made to either get you oxygen somehow. Cylinder, concentrator, anything which can give you some time, 6, 8, 10, 20, 24 hours till the hospital bed comes up.
Okay.
At the same time, to add to his point, steroid medications are very useful. What we learnt in July last year is steroids, and steroids are pills anybody can eat. So your doctor will give you the right dose of steroid. So
in the steroid, what is all that?
So steroid basically is based on the fact that the immune system is going crazy. Immune and COVID are fighting with each other. This time COVID is going down, but the immune system is causing a problem. So for that, to make the immune system come under control, steroid pills are given. Steroids are very familiar to people who have asthma, lung disease and all. We know it because we grow up with steroids. So those things taken as a pill a day can actually save your life by around 50%. So if you don't have a hospital, just lie down on your back, call your doctor, and if he thinks it's the right thing, take steroid pills. Maybe that will save your life before you reach the
hospital. Okay, doctor. ಈಗ ಸ್ಟೀರಾಯ್ಡು ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ನು ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗೋದು ಈಗ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೇ ಈಗ ಕೆಲವರೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಹೋಗಿನ ಮುಂಚಿತವಾಗಿ ಕೆಲವರೆಲ್ಲ ಮೆಣಸು ತಿನ್ನಬೇಕು ಅದು ತಿನ್ನಬೇಕು ನಾಟಿ ಏನೇನೋ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಫುಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್
ಯಾ ಸೊ ಐ ವಿಶ್ ಟು ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರೋಪತಿ ಆಯುರ್ವೇದ ಯುನಾನಿ ವಿ ಆಲ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಶುಡ್ ಕಮ್ ಐ ವಿಶ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಐ ವಿಶ್ ಐ ಕುಡ್ ಗೋ ಇನ್ ಟು ಹಿಸ್ ಲವ್ಲಿ ಗಾರ್ಡನ್ ಪಿಕ್ ಔಟ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಚ್ ವುಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್ Scientifically, there is nothing. And I'm sad to say that. I also like naturopathic stuff, fruits and all. Scientifically, there is nothing. I will go on record as saying even Baba Ramdev's medication, Coronil, has no scientific role at this point. Nothing. Even the vitamins you take, vitamin C, zinc and all, nothing. At this point, nothing works. I'll tell you simply why.
Humanity nellikai tinbeku antare. Adyado innond tinni ante heltare. Enano kelavella kaalugalu tinni ante heltare.
Nothing. So the Ayurvedic specialists are giving something which they believe works. Scientifically not proven. Is it harmful? No, it's not harmful. Please take it. We are also very liberal. Please take anything you want. But don't depend on it. Because if taking it, you stop measuring oxygen, you don't do this, you don't take the steroid pill, then you are taking a risk with your own life, which is not advisable.
Okay. ಈ ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ಗೆ ಸೇರಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಈಗ ನೀವು ಸ್ಟೀರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ಬೇರೆ ಇದನ್ನ ಈ ಒಂದು ಮೈಕೈಲ್ ನೋವುದೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ಈ ರೆಮಿಡಿಸಿವಿರ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪಿಡುಗು ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅದಿದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾವು ಬದುಕ್ತೀವಿ ನನಗೆ ಡೈಲಿ ನೂರಾರು ಫೋನ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಈ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ಡಿ ಎಚ್ ಒ ಇದು ಡ್ರಗ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲರ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಅವ್ರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವರೇನು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಿನ್ನೆ ಎಂ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ ಅವರು ಪಾಪ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅವ್ರ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟ್ಲ್ಗೇನೆ ಇದು ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಗಾಬರಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಇದು ಬೇಕು 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 ಒಂದು ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಕೊಡಿ ಎರಡು ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಕೊಡಿ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಎರಡು ಕೊಡಿ ಮೂರು ಕೊಡಿ ಐದು ಕೊಡಿ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಇದನ್ನ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್
The word remdesivir has become more common than saying air, water or food basically. Instead of food, I think we should be talking about how we can eat remdesivir. So this remdesivir, again, everything will have a small 30-second background. In last year, we had no medication for COVID. Hydroxychloroquine, which we sent to Trump by a big plane, useless. Most of the medications, useless. So remdesivir came as an injection, which when given for COVID is going to improve. Since we did not understand COVID, see, everybody was learning. So many people were supposed to be candidates for remdesivir. Look at my hand, so many people. But over the last 1 year, when people got smarter, it is now realized that only so many people need remdesivir. Who are those people? Only if your oxygen falls below 93-94% with COVID before 9 days. And we have published this in India. We are very proud to say with all our colleagues, it is accepted internationally before 9 days of illness. Not the test, ladies and gentlemen, illness. Today I had sore throat, that is day one of my disease, not day five when I got my test. So from the illness, within 9 days, for people with moderate to severe COVID-19, remdesivir will shorten hospital stay. It does not improve lives, will shorten hospital stay. When you understand that, you will accept the fact, everybody don't give it to me. Is it required? Let my doctor tell me. If it is not required, let my friend who is suffering there get it, who actually needs it, and I don't need it. So people will calm down, realize that it is not a hammer or a magic wand, and will allow the healthcare system to give it to those who actually require it till the stocks come.
Doctor, when actually I should knock the door of the hospital? Yav sandarbhadalli lastalli iga iranta sandarbhadalli nan hospital ge compulsory agi hoglebeku annanta paristhiti yavaga?
Talking as a non-doctor, my fever is not coming down. It is going 101, 102, 103 after 5 to 6 days. Up to 5 to 6 days you can watch, assuming you are healthy. Of course, you have diabetes, blood pressure and all, it's a different situation. So currently understanding that this wave is causing 50% of the people in our ICU, sir, are young people right now. So if my fever goes on and on, it's increasing. I am feeling sicker and very weak. Most importantly, I repeat, most importantly, oxygen levels falls less than 93% or 94%. Okay, no lipstick, no nail polish out here. I walk and it's still low. I am not feeling well. That is the time you need a hospital. Before that, please don't knock on the hospital. Last year, our hospitals were full of people who just came there, ate food and went away. Nothing happened to them. Unless you are sick, don't reach the hospital. Sir's point is very clear. Leave the hospital for the people who require it. If you and I go and sit there without a reason, some young fellow who is my brother, my father, my friend will die. So this has to be heard very carefully.
In this wave, doctor, this wave, why youngsters are dying? Why youngsters have been lot of problem to youngsters? Earlier it was only, we were just speaking, knowing the news, only above 60 it used to attach. Now we could see lot of youngsters, 30, 40, 25, 45, all this younger age have been attracted to this. How is this?
Yeah, so it's a very sad thing, you know, and all of our voices go down with tragedy when we walk in the ICU, 25-year-old, 28, 38, 40, 45. The few reasons for this is the following. A, we vaccinated the elderly when we started. We did not give the vaccine to the younger people. And that was part of international policy and we have changed it now, so we'll have to see how it goes. So elderly got vaccinated partly. Youngsters did not get vaccinated. B, the most mobile people are the youngsters. They go to work, they go to celebrations, they go and meet in restaurants, they are the most mobile. So this is the two major reasons. Thirdly, the strain may have mutated. You had made a point in the beginning, the mutant strain. So the mutant strain itself is attacking everybody with the same energy. Before, we felt youngsters had immunity. So they would be able to fight it off. Currently, because of that, they don't seem to be fighting it off. So these three reasons mainly, we are seeing a large population of young people coming to hospital and ICUs.
Mm. Doctor, what are the other medicines which we can, for emergency sake, we can keep at home?
Yeah. Main thing at this point at home, after learning that COVID requires so many medications, is nothing. COVID only requires this much. Everything is symptomatic. What you did for any viral illness is what you do for COVID. In short, I have fever, I need paracetamol. If I have nausea, I need simple things like anti-nausea medication, Domstal or something. If I have acidity, I need simple Rantac, Pantodac. If I have body ache, again, I can serve with paracetamol. So these are the simplest medications. In addition, many people like to take vitamins. So vitamin C, zinc and vitamin D is being given to everybody. One common pill is available. Beyond that, there is hardly any medication. Now, a lot of people like this pill called ivermectin. An antiviral pill. If you look at guidelines who are strict guidelines coming from everywhere, ivermectin is never proven. However, some Indian guidelines have said ivermectin can be given. Since it is not harmful, it can be given. But none of us are saying that it is going to save your life. So in short, very simple. Keep paracetamol, keep antacid, keep anti-vomiting medication, drink a lot of water, eat healthy food, which was in addition to what sir said, and that should be good enough. Stay in touch with your doctor. Many doctors are available, ladies and gentlemen. General practitioner to specialist, everybody is willing. Government has arranged, pro bono has arranged. You know, our colleagues here are arranging. People are available to you online. You don't need to see anybody's face for this disease.
Doctor, when we have a test, we get positive symptoms. But my friends are all right. I have a lot of my friends who traveled abroad, who came abroad. Then they went to the airport. When they came out, they said they are positive. But they are comfortably okay. What is that? Sometimes when RTPS test is done negative, and then also the same time of issues are there.
Yeah.
How it is?
So this is the thing. Actually, it is not a very dangerous virus. It is dangerous because it is infective. So very simple. If I have a small village out there and the village has 20 people, this virus cannot cause any problems. It is when we have these crowded cities that we have a problem. So, why I am telling you this is 80 to 90% people fall under the category of asymptomatic, which means that it comes and sits here. My immune system fought it off. I never knew what was going on. The only problem is that I am infective to others. And some one fellow out of 10 who is diabetic, hypertensive will get affected. Because millions are getting affected, that is why the problem has come.
Doctors, today a lot of my local doctors in the villages are watching this show. My doctor cells and lot of friends. What is your advice to all these doctors? They are all village people. They are not a profession big with a big name or with the experience, or they are not well equipped with like you. What do you advise them?
So, again, sir, for COVID-19, you don't need to be us. Ultimately, I speak language because of knowledge and education and understanding. You are just as good as me, because COVID-19 requires only this much understanding. Again, I'll be very happy to share very small, basic write-ups, very basic, A, B, C, D, E, which can be disseminated to all our friends over there. Friends, you are just as smart as anybody else. You are just as smart as anybody else. You just have to understand the disease and be calm and be the strength which your village can depend upon. Ultimately, they are going to come to you. If you worry or you don't know, they will not know. So you just have to know this thing, first week, second week. First week, simple medications, nothing to be done like we talked about. Second week, problem can come. Measure fever and oxygen saturation. If we are getting sicker, look for a hospital. If hospital is not there, get oxygen and steroid. 95% of COVID is covered in this. 3 minutes to summarize 1 year.
Doctor, I am looking at the papers. I am reading all the papers. In Bharat, Mexico, Berbera Rajyalu, all these numbers are getting higher. ಯಾಕೆ ನ್ಯೂಜಿಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಇಸ್ರೇಲು, ಆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲೇನಿಲ್ವಲ್ಲ? ನನ್ನ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಜನ ಆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಲಿಯಾದಿಂದ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ನ್ಯೂಜಿಲ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂದ 3-4 ಜನ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಜನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಓಡಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪರಿಸರ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೂ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ, ಯಾಕೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಯಾಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಿದೆ?
ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್. ದಟ್ ದೋಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್, ನ್ಯೂಜಿಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ 4 million ಪೀಪಲ್. 4 million ಇಸ್ 40 lakhs. 40 lakh ಪೀಪಲ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ನ್ಯೂಜಿಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ 2 sheep. This is the population of the country. So they have a very strong forum where they decided that if anybody enters COVID, they will shut them down for 2 weeks. So in the initial stage of COVID, and I'm reminded of Bangalore in April and May of 2020, if you can contain, if COVID comes in, test, and if testing is done 14 days, you keep them at home, and all the family members are tested, contact tracing, you can control COVID. But COVID is like a race. All of us have done running races. So if you start the race and you start running, once COVID starts running, everybody gets exhausted. It will spread fast. The authorities cannot do anything. People are running all over the place. Contact tracing breaks down. Testing breaks down. After that, we reach the stage of what America had, UK had, Brazil had, Italy had, Germany had, and now India is having.
Doctor, in Karnataka, in India and Karnataka, we have the highest number of medical colleges. It is called the health tourism place. We have highest number of human resources, nurses, all this medical good equipments are there, hospitals are there. Lot of this compared to other part of the country. Bangalore and Karnataka has that big strength. Why we are not able to control this in this state?
Yeah.
Forget the other places. I don't want to come and compare. Yesterday, Kamal Nath spoke to me. Some of my friends from UP spoke to me. I don't want to blame those states. But in the state like Karnataka, we are so progressive. Why would not able to contain this?
Yeah, so it's a very policy-based decision, and I think a whole discussion can happen. Ultimately, it's unfortunate because our people are suffering. At this point, what has happened, I think a lot of lessons have to be learned. We should learn those lessons so that when the next wave comes, ever it comes, we should do the right thing. But currently we require the highest level of public, private, not partnership, brothership, I would say. We need to all get together as one family to fight this particular disease. And I have one message, ladies and gentlemen, it is within us now. They say God is in our heart. Similarly, preventing COVID is in our own control if we do what we're doing right now. So this is the way ahead. These lessons, and secondly, all these lessons, as he's trying to point out, what led to this, what is ultimately a lack of success on our part, should be used, because in the future, both of us don't want to sit and do this session again and again for the third wave or something on those lines.
You are just trying to tell me that some wave, one second wave, third wave, you are telling. Is there any possibility of having a third wave, doctor?
Yes, sir. So, it is, again, it does not come from my mouth. We are messengers and we are not the ones bringing. Already the question is, in countries of the world where the second has happened, the third is talked about already. See, because the vaccine is good for 6 to 9 months. and the vaccine has come in the shortest time possible. They need to work on it and make it better and better. So it's very possible, just like, so we have to learn, right? When first wave went away, we said we are done, let's go back to normal life, let's go back to elections, let's go back to melas, everything. But when this goes away, it's possible that after 3 to 6 months, a third wave may come. So it's very, very important that we learn all the lessons now, all the lessons, and prepare everything from government, private and individual sides to make sure that we never have this conversation again.
Now, in the media, we are seeing from past 2 days that even in the air it has been transferred. How is that in the air? Well, then where is the protection for it? If it is in the air, it may travel from anywhere.
Yeah, it's a very core question. So the thing is, before it was imagined, I'll make some actions. Before it was imagined that it is spread by drops. So the thing was that I cough, a drop goes here, and the drop goes and sits here. It is here, and if somebody else comes and breathes from here or touches here or goes here, we are going to get COVID. The current theory is that when we talk, when we cough, or when we sneeze, these particles are hanging out here. So I did this over here and I went away. The next person comes in, he does not know these are there, he breathes this and he gets COVID. After 1 year, 60% of COVID is going by these aerosols. So each one of our environment. So typically that is what has happened. I went into the hotel, before me one COVID fellow was there, but they were asymptomatic. He was breathing over there, these particles are there. I go with my family, I eat, I come back, I get COVID. Then I transmit it to my father, my mother. So it's very important to realize every part of the air in this point, if some human has gone over there, could be having remnants of COVID.
So you are telling that we should be very cautious while moving outside also.
Outside is the main place.
Main place. That is why government is telling you better be at home.
Yeah. Simple. When you have injury, you have pain, you say no problem. You apply some medication, you stop. Similarly, you assume this mask is part of my body.
Okay.
It's part of my body. That is nothing else. It is not wear a mask. It is where is my mask? It should be. When we change the mentality from give me a mask to please don't take off my mask, we can fight this for now.
Okay. What is the best diet for a COVID patient? A COVID patient ke ondolle uta yenu doctor?
Just healthy diet, sir. So currently Ayurvedic people are recommending something. I am not expert in that, but I don't think it has any scientific basis. But go ahead and take in. Healthy diet, drink water 2 to 2.5 liters a day, eat normal food. If the appetite goes down because of fever, don't worry, don't push food in yourself. The body is just telling you to adjust. Healthy food, water, very important, that is all. Nothing else is required.
Doctor, when do you see that this will try to stop?
So we'll borrow from other countries. You know, sir brought up Mexico, Brazil and so on. 2 days ago, Israel has declared that people in Israel can move around in open areas without a mask. So it is possible. So over time, we hope that we can first of all save lives now. Secondly, then the transmission will come down, and then hopefully vaccination will kick in. So currently, if we are having this Janta curfew or lockdown now, at least in 2 to 3 weeks, we will see the cases coming down. And this happened in Bombay. Yesterday Bombay was 5,000 or something. So, typically 2 weeks after the lockdown. So, if we start now, 2 weeks from now, the cases will come down. 4 to 6 weeks from now, we start looking at more control. Average duration of any cycle, any wave is around 3 to 4 months. Average duration in most countries. By that time, we hope that we all get smarter. We are able to discipline both ourselves and between government, individual and everybody. We can get highest level of control, so at least some normal life. But ladies and gentlemen, I don't think this fellow is going to go away. The mask is going to be there for a long time. Somebody had told us in 2020, sir, that full 2021 had gone. And we said, no. Looks like 2021 will be the year of the mask.
Will definitely this vaccines help us?
At this point, yes. It is
because,
like...
Because my chief minister had a vaccine.
Yeah.
Then again, he had a COVID. Then again, forget the other common man. Chief Minister had a COVID once, then again he had a COVID, he had taken vaccine, he had finished his routine checkup. When our leaders themselves get into this problem, whether this vaccine is working?
So the one thing is, of course, that let us look at the vaccine success. The vaccine success goes from 62% to 79%. That means that whatever we do, 62% to 79% means anywhere from 30% to 40% people will not get protection, especially people who are elderly, diabetes, blood pressure and all. With due respect to our leaders, ultimately the body is the body. And if you see our leaders, including all of you, you probably work more and meet thousands of more people than we ever have to meet. So that is something which is professional. Secondly, let us not forget one thing, one unique part of the vaccines. What worries me in COVID now? I'm not worried about COVID. I'm only worried about hospitalization, death, and losing all my money, as he pointed out. Hospitalization, dying, and my family gets into trouble because I'm wiped out. Vaccines allow limit the disease to mild. They take severe disease and they don't allow severe disease to happen. It's usually only mild disease. Mild disease, I can sit at home. I can, you know, do whatever I want. 10 days I'm home and fine. So if any vaccine can avoid hospitalization, avoid death, the job is done. Current vaccine seems to be 90%+ good in avoiding hospitalization, avoiding death. Even the chief minister, I'm told, was discharged in 3 days and he was basically kept there for caution. By and large, otherwise home isolation is the treatment for most people who've got vaccination.
Is there any medicine which prevents the infection in this?
Unfortunately, no. It is only faith that I will take coronal, I will take that. Nothing prevents infection. Once it comes, it comes. The only thing we have is what has worked for 2000 years, immune system.
Will anything is there for people to develop immunity on COVID?
Good food, healthy lifestyle, no smoking, drinking, you know, too much is always a problem. Don't take any abusive substances.
How much we can drink, doctor?
Very good question. Should I answer that one?
Sure.
Once or twice a week is not a problem in moderation.
Okay,
this other doctors may not agree with me, but most of us in this generation agree, because once or twice a week in moderation is okay. But daily alcohol intake, regular smoking intake is a problem. So just eat healthy, drink water, avoid these things, and avoid masking and social distancing. That is it.
Okay, thank you, doctor. You have shared a lot of issues. Definitely, I think with this, a lot of my friends, a lot of my people in the state and all over the country, they have watched this great show, what you have given, good suggestions. There are still a lot of things to discuss in the future days, we will discuss. I thank you for coming. One uttumadanta salegalanna namma Dr. Mehta avaru, Ravindra Mehta avaru kottidare. Bosha avara anubhava avara maatnalli bosha tavella tilkondidiri. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ರು ಏನೇನು ಕೆಲವು ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ರು ನಾನು ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ನಿಮಗೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನನ್ನ ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಹಾಕ್ತೇನೆ ಅದನ್ನು. ಅವ್ರು ಏನೇನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಲೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ರು ಏನೇನು ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ ಬರೋ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ಭಾಳ ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯ ಜನರು, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಂಥ ಒಂದು ವಿಚಾರವನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಹಂಚ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ತಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡ ನಾಗರಿಕರು, ನಮ್ಮ ಬದುಕನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕೆ, ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ಮೊದಲು ಜೀವ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಜೀವನ, ಈ ಜೀವನವನ್ನು ಉಳಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಇಂಥ ದೊಡ್ಡ ತಜ್ಞರ ಸಲಹೆ ಸಹಕಾರ ನಮಗೆ ಭಾಳ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಇವರು ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಆನ್ ಬಿಹಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ. ಐ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಯುವರ್ ಸಲಹೆ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಮೀ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿ ಮಾಸ್ಕ್ ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಹೋಮ್. ಫ್ರಮ್ ಟುಡೇ ಐ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಾಸ್ಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಹೋಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಐ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಾಸ್ಕ್. ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಲಿಟ್ಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ I used to feel some breathing problems. Somehow I got some good mask. One of my friends has got me a good mask from German. So I think I could breathe well in this mask. Thank you. Definitely we will see that. From my party also, today we had a lot of meeting with a lot of senior leaders. We would like to have a care center also. Anything is there, we will call you back. We will request you for your suggestion. Your service is for a mankind, for the humanity. I wish you all the best, doctor. May God be with you. We all are there with you. You have helped me. You have made me strong. You have given me suggestions. You have me brought back from the hospital to the home. So I would like to thank, and all my people would like to thank you for this great service. Thank you so much, sir.
And I hope that all of us come out of this healthy and happy, so that we can be together, beat this particular situation. We look forward to everyone's help and leadership. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಚಾನಲ್ಗೆ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗಿ.